celebrating all the women in my life. As you know, I have worked with Anna Luisa in the past, and I really love the sustainability of the jewelry. Anna Luisa is a 100% was very passionate about recycling and had like a deep love and respect for nature. Rachel was described by her friends as being very sweet. She was always smiling and kind of goofy. On January 31st, 1996, Rachel was home from school sick. She had been feeling kind of congested. This winter in Illinois was bitterly cold, and I mean freezing. The high for the day was 6 degrees Fahrenheit, and it was also super windy, so with the wind chill, it felt even colder. Rachel's younger siblings had gone to school that day, and her mother had gone to work. She was home with her stepfather, Vince, who was unemployed. That morning, Rachel called her father's parents, so her grandparents, to thank them for the Christmas gift they had sent her. She mentioned that she was home from school, that she wasn't feeling well, and that her stepfather was also home with her. Rachel was doing kind of what any teen would do when they're homesick, lounging around in super comfy clothes. She was wearing a pink sweater and yellow sweatpants. Her stepfather would later tell police that the last time he saw her, she was asleep on her bed, kind of snuggled up under a blue blanket. He said that around noon, he and Rachel had played Nintendo for a while, but she got really tired and decided she wanted to go upstairs and have a nap. Around 2:30, he took the family dog, Duke, for a walk. And on this walk, the dog saw a rabbit and was able to like slip out of its collar and took off. Vince said he was gone for about a half hour, and he returned home alone because he was never able to catch up with the dog. He would later say that a real estate appraiser found the dog and brought him back home. At 3:30, Rachel's sister got home from school and noticed Rachel wasn't home. And when her mother, Amy, arrived home that night from work, the family told her that Rachel was missing. Amy and Vince are not overly concerned by this information because about 6 months earlier, Rachel had run away from home. I guess her brother and sister had broken something in the home, and she was worried that she was going to get in trouble or blamed for it. So she left a note and then went to a friend's house and slept at this friend's house. And then the next morning called her grandparents and told them where she was. And they came and got her and drove her back home. So she was gone like a runaway for about 12 hours. So when Rachel comes up missing this January day, I guess her parents just assumed maybe she had run away again. However, by 6 p.m. that night, police were notified that she was missing. But because she had a history of running away, police believed initially that's exactly what had happened last seen her. The next morning, when Rachel still hasn't surfaced, police file an official missing persons case and they begin looking for her. The melanome was searched, and police said the only items missing from the home, the only items from Rachel's bedroom, were two pillows and a blue blanket, the same one that she had been snuggled up asleep under when her stepfather had gone to walk the dog. Oddly enough, Rachel's purse with money inside, shoes, her coats, hats, scarves, all of her warm weather items were still in her bedroom. So it would seem like a 13-year-old girl who wasn't feeling well had left home in her red slippers in the middle of winter with no shoes. Officially Thank you. Mellon was arrested for domestic battery. He was arrested for domestic battery again in 2004 for assaulting his wife and his son. By the end of the year, he had 3 warrants for failing to appear in court. In 2005, Amy and Vince were arrested after they had stayed at a hotel for several days and then skipped out on their bill. Later that year, Vince was leaving a strip club, driving very intoxicated, and he hit a car. And the person driving this car was a journalist named Dave Wilson. So Vince is arrested. Were there. I do not think this girl ran away. was taken. Slippers. sense to me. I do not think that a stranger came into her house and abducted her, like, at all. A random side note here, but Drew Peterson, who is a convicted killer whose story I will cover in the next week or two, was a police officer on the Bolingbrook PD and helped investigate this case. So that's just kind of a weird side. I just quickly want to cite my sources for this video. I got information from the Charlie Project, the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, the Polyglass Foundation, off sale going on right now. Click the link down in the description.